short, we go to our word of the day. Our word of the day comes from the book of Romans, chapter 8, verse 5. Romans, chapter 8, verse 5. It says, for those who live according to the flesh set their minds on the things of the flesh, but those who live according to the Spirit, the things of the Spirit. Amen. For those who live according to the flesh set their minds on the things of the flesh, but those who live according to the Spirit, the things of the Spirit. Amen. Praise the Lord. So when God calls us and we receive salvation, we are given the gift of the Holy Spirit. We're alive in the Spirit, born again, and then we quickly discover, like it says in Romans 7, for what I am doing, I do not understand. For what I will to do, that I do not practice. But what I hate, that I do. And so there's two people in us. There's this old man, this flesh man that wants to do the things against God, wants to follow the law, wants to do the things in the world and the flesh, and cannot even deal with anything of God. Yet we have a spirit man, our inner man, the one that wants to do the will of God, yet there's this battle that goes on, the spirit and the flesh. How do we overcome the flesh? Hosea 4 says, my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. So there must be something we need to know to overcome this flesh. 2 Corinthians 10 says, but I beg you that when I am present with you, I may not be bold with that confidence by which I intend to be bold against some who think of us as we walk according to the flesh. For though we walk in the flesh, we do not war according to the flesh. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal or fleshly, but mighty in God for pulling down strongholds, casting down arguments, and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, bringing every thought into captivity to the obedience of Christ. Amen. Praise the Lord. So you see, it is about we must have knowledge. 1 John chapter 2 says, I've written to you young men because you are strong and the word of God abides in you and you have overcome the wicked one. To overcome the wicked one, to overcome the flesh, is to know God, to have knowledge of God. And we see that when the word of God abides in us, we are strong. We are able to cast down every argument that comes against the word of God because we have the word of God in us. The win over the flesh, let the spirit be strengthened through the word of God, and then it takes every thought captive that tries to draw us to follow our flesh. Now, can we do this on our own strength? No. But if we understand that this is the answer, then our desire is to ask God to cause us to turn our eyes from worthless things and put it all into him, to get to know him. And the more that we know him, the more our faith is increased, the less cracks in our armor that the enemy gets through and causes us to stumble until we come to that perfect man full of faith, sealed up and resting in Christ completely. That is the way that we overcome the flesh. Lord, we ask you to help us live according to the Spirit. Help us focus on the things of the Spirit, which is your word. Cause us to do this very thing, because now we know from your word that you're the author and finisher of our faith, that it's through hearing your word that we grow, but you have to be the one that does it in us. We ask for this, and we know your word says if we ask, you will answer, because it is according to your will. So give us that heart today. Cause us to be focused on getting to know you, and then all the fiery darts of the evil one will have no power over us, and we will grow and live forever with you. We thank you for this word. Make it a reality in our lives in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Praise the Lord.